Oh shit! We're fucked now, buddy! We are so fucked!
Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Wings, and welcome to a game called Astroneer, a game about being an astronaut on a weird foreign planet that we have to build on and survive on and try not to suffocate. Which I've already done a lot of times. I've played this game just a little bit just to know what I'm getting myself into, so I know the general basics of what I need to do starting off, but other than that I have no clue. I played a little, built a few things, got lost, died a lot, fell under the map. Yeah, this game's really, really buggy, by the way. It's still in pre-alpha, as you can see. It says pre-alpha build, so there's a lot wrong with it right now, but for what it is, it's actually really good. So I actually have a world that I started, but we're not gonna play on that one. I'm gonna start a new one just for you guys, and I didn't mean to do that, but we're gonna go ahead and jump right into it. So as you can see, when you start off, you actually orbit in, like there's no like main menu, you just jump right into it, which is fucking cool, by the way. I like how you just drop in, like, you know. And the load, like, it's pretty buggy when it first loads in, but once it loads in, it's actually really cool looking. And this is not like a highly graphical game, like the graphics are like this for a reason, I'm assuming, but it works for the game. Look at me, I'm a cute little spaceman, look at me, I'm so cool looking. Okay, so this is your shuttle. Your shuttle is the one place when you start out that you have an infinite supply of oxygen and you don't have to worry about too much. As long as you're next to your shuttle, you're perfectly fine. Your shuttle is your only source of shelter whenever a dust storm comes in, or a rune rock storm, I don't know what it's called. But when a storm comes in, you get your shuttle and you're safe. As of right now, that little blue line, that's my tether. That's how far, see if I go out of range, see it stops. And my oxygen, which is a blue tank on my back, you can see right up here, that's my oxygen. And this is my power, we'll get to that in a second. Oxygen's draining, I get close to it, it retethers, and my oxygen fills back up. So, this little thing right here, right there, that's used to build structures off of your shuttle. So you kind of start with your shuttle and then you expand out as you go. So this is compound. This is a crucial part of the game. These are key ingredients to just about everything. Compound is used for a lot of stuff. So you get out your little sucker doohickey, your big, I just smacked the shit out of the microphone. Your big suck-shadooter, your big blowjob machine, and you start sucking away. You just get all that rock hard sustenance. You just suck it all up. And then you're out of battery now. You can run back to your shuttle. It really doesn't charge it that much faster. Anyways, so we're going to try to get a little more. You can actually go first person to make it a little easier, because you don't actually have to just hold down the trigger. You can just kind of feather it, because as soon as you break it, like as soon as like it has no more ground to sit on, it gives you the material. Okay, so I think I've exhausted this area. Now, there's probably more underneath. Yeah, see, there's more down underneath it. But we're not going to get any more for right now, because we have enough. So what we're going to start with right now is we're going to go ahead and expand out one. So we're going to come right back here. And we're going to go ahead and come out one. So this requires one resin, which we do not have. So I thought for a second. Okay, so what we're going to do so we don't suffocate while we're out there, we're going to build a tether. Now, tethers are used to link your base to a certain distance. So you can press down the D-pad. I'm on Xbox One, by the way. This is a computer. Press down the D-pad and you get on a tether. Now, your tether will reach right there. You drop your tether and now you have an extended area to where you can resupply oxygen. And if you have power running from it, it'll resupply your power too. So we're going to go ahead and drop a few tethers and make our way out here and look for some res. You want to get the max distance off of it so you don't waste it. Because if you're just putting them right next to each other, you're not getting the most use out of it. So I see a structure out there. I don't know much about the game. I just know how to build certain things, and I know about certain materials. I know basically the essential materials that you need to start off. Because I've only played for like maybe a couple hours, like 2, maybe 3 hours. So I haven't played too long. And I don't know where the fuck we're going, to be honest. I'm gonna go ahead and use up all these tethers to get me out here. Just look at this though, it's gorgeous. It is so beautiful. Let me get that tether gone. Tethers can actually reach. Let's put that there. Okay, it's not gonna fall. So I wonder if this tether can reach over. Yeah, it can. Is it gonna fall? It's not. Okay, sweet. And you can actually, that cave right there, if you have the tether, like, above the wall and it's, like, you're close enough to it, you can reach through the cave. Okay, I'm out of tethers. So we're gonna have to, okay. Didn't know that did that. So this is copper. Copper is an essential. Well, it's one of the essential. Organic. You can get that pretty easily from just, sucking up grass and stuff like that. You get organic from, basic materials. Like, I'd get organic from this stuff if I tried to suck it out. So we're just looking for some, fuck, I already forgot what it's called. Well, when I find it, I'll show you. Should be some. Okay, my oxygen's getting low, so I need to start heading back to the tether. Just to play it safe, because I've died way too much in this game already. And we don't want to go down the road again, so... What we're going to do real quick is we're actually going to go and check the cave. We're going to build some more tethers just so we can get down there without losing oxygen. Alright, so get out of that. So as you can see, you can place the tether down here and it'll link. You can just kind of run the tether. When's it going to stop right there? Go back right there. You can just run the tether. This will be like our primary cave because obviously the tether has a line to it, so you can just kind of follow your tethers to caves. And caves are really cool in this game. Okay, it looks like, yeah, everything we need right now is down here. So we're gonna go ahead and carefully construct a way down without... I wanna flatten out some of this up here, make it a little bit lower. I don't know if that's... Okay, that should be low enough. If it's not, we can always fix it. Yeah, okay, we can get up and down. So yeah, as you can see, the game's still a little buggy. There's some bugs here and there, but... Other than that, the game's actually really good. So we're gonna put that away. What was that noise? Oh, one thing about this game, there are no... hostiles. I don't know what that sound was. Like a zombie just comes out of nowhere and just kills me. There are no, like, enemies. But you can be killed by, like, the plant life. Like, the plant life can give off these weird spore things. Okay, that one's not... It's not giving me that one. And, like, the spore dust or whatever that comes off of it can actually kill you. So you have to be really careful. What is... This is what we need. And I forgot what this is called. This is what we need. This is called... I can't see it until I suck up enough of it. There's probably more. Yeah, there's more on the roof. Okay. Alright, we almost have enough for a stack. Okay. I need to get back to the tether because I'm suffocating. Okay, there we go. I need to put a tether down here. That's what I failed to do. So let's go ahead and drop it right there. There we go. Now we have some oxygen down here. So as you see, you can dig pretty far into the structures. You can actually dig infinitely, I think, all the way to the other side of the planet because you are on a rounded planet. You're on the surface of it and you can walk. I'm pretty sure you can go all the way around it, but if you go around it too fast, like I did, like I had a rover, and I went too fast, and I ended up following through the map because the map didn't load as fast as I was going. So we're gonna try to get one more stack of this. Should be enough. Yeah, okay. So we have two stacks of this. We actually... We need to get one more stack, so I'm gonna try to get rid of these tethers real quick. Just gonna place these out. Okay. I want to at least have a way down there if I have a tether down there. Okay, we're going to try to get one more stack of, what was this? Resin. Resin, that's what it's called. Okay, we need one more stack of resin to be able to form a structure once we have our pad built. actually a lot right here. Should be enough. No, not enough. Okay. It's never enough. It's never enough, you greedy son of a bitch. Okay. Come on. And it's a little wonky, yes. And like I said, the game is still in pre-alpha, so it's gonna be like that. But for what they have right now, it's really cool. Like it's really cool what they got. Sorry, I'm just Well, by now, if you've watched my videos, you know what I'm doing when I look over the computer. I'm checking to make sure it's recording properly, because I don't wanna get through this video and then it fuck up. That would be really annoying. Okay, why did I do that? And you can see it holds on to the suction gun actually holds on to whatever you have, and it'll hang on to that until you complete the stack. But if you get a different resource, it'll override it and you'll lose that resource. Okay, so you want to stay close to your tether when you're running, because running does deplete your oxygen a little faster. So we should... Wait a minute. Oh, shit. Oh, no. I gotta go back. Hold on, guys. I'll be right back. There you are, you little shit. Come with me. Okay. Sorry about that. I had to come back down here and get it, because I didn't put out all my tethers, so there wasn't a free slot in my inventory. So I didn't get the third resin, but we're on the right track now. So anyways, what I was saying, we have the resources we need to start constructing our base. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and place the resin. And that's going to give us a pad. Now you can do one of two things with a pad, or a double pad, I don't know what you want to call it. You can put two resin on it and get a structure such as a printer or a vehicle depot or a smelter, whatever you want, blah, 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 blah. One of those. Or you can expand it out again and make this just kind of like a console for you to put double things on it or to hold stuff. So you can use any of these structures to hold your material if they start filling up your backpack. So we're going to go ahead and put that on there. So now we have a structure. So the first thing we're going to do... We should probably... We're gonna get a printer first, but we need copper. And do we have any copper? We have copper ore. Actually, you know what? No, we have copper ore. So we need to go ahead and make a smelter. And that needs compound. So once you put the compound on there... And in front of your very eyes, it forms a... A smelter. So that's awesome. Look at that. Look at the planet going down, and it's just like... It's moving up there. Look at that. Beautiful. Okay. So now we have a smelter. It needs power. Now you can get power multiple ways. But the easiest way I've found to get power, and this only works during the daytime. Not a generator. You actually, you can make a generator, but generators are a little bit more annoying to use. Yeah, we need compound. So, we're gonna go look for some more compound really quick. Oh, there's some over there. Sweet. We gotta get it fast, though, because we're not on the tether. And eventually, you can get a bigger tank. And, it'll hold more oxygen. But until then, you just kinda have to deal. And the game doesn't really have that much of a tutorial. Like, you saw when I got out. It didn't explain what to do. It just kind of throws you into it, which is fine, because the game's not that hard to figure out. It's kind of self-explanatory. As you go, you'll figure it out on your own, and if you don't figure it out, then you're not very smart. Sorry. It's true. I mean, I'm not very smart, but I figured it out. Okay. Oxygen's at 50, so we need to hurry up and get as much as we can. Come on, we want one more. Come on. One more. Damn it. Is there more? There's one more. I see it. Is that it? Yes. Okay. Now we need to get back. Come on. There's the tether. You can make it, buddy. You can make it. I have faith in you. Okay. We made it. Alrighty. So. No, put that away. Okay. So now that we're here, we're going to go ahead and make a solar panel. Now, these only work during the day, obviously, because they're solar panels. So we're going to make one of those bad boys. And we're going to make two, actually, because we're going to keep one on us. Because this, if, as you can see, now I have a solar panel right there on the left of my, my voice cracked. On the left of my backpack. And that'll make, this is my power for my suction. And when during the daytime, the solar panel will make it charge faster. So we're going to leave that. We're going to make one more. And that'll go, right? Oh, okay, I have two solar. That's cool looking. That's really cool looking, but I can't keep both of them, so. I'll take it, okay. So we're gonna put the solar panel right there. And that, see, that's charging it. That's giving it power. So the power, you see the power running to it? So it's charging it up. Now you can't smelt anything until it's completely charged. And it's going pretty slow, so Let's make another solar panel. It's gonna put it right there. Yeah, we're gonna put one more solar panel. Oh shit, one more solar panel. And now it's going a little faster. Okay, more power. And this works from any of the placeable areas. Like you can place it on there, you can place it on these two areas, you can place it on this, these two over here. It doesn't matter where you place it because it's all running to the same place. However, for example, if you had like a structure that ran way out here, as opposed to having one right here, the power is going to take just a little longer to get to it, so it's gonna fill up at just a slightly slower rate. But it's not a big deal. So now that we have the smelter ready, we're going to go ahead and put the ore on here. And you want to wait until you have a sufficient amount of ore, because if you just smelt one, you're wasting all the power just to smelt one ore, because a full thing will smelt all four of these, but it takes a full thing to smelt just one. So you want to wait till you have all four of them and go ahead and get all the ore you can. And see, it'll hold it for you right there. And you want to be careful, because if you have all four of these filled up and you don't have any room, if you try to like smelt another ore, it'll override it and you'll lose a copper if it's copper, or you'll lose aluminum if it's aluminum. Okay, so now that we have that built, we need to go ahead and expand out again. Oh shit, I need resin. All right, we gotta get some more resin. Let's make some more tethers real quick. All right. God, this game is so pretty. Like, everything's all shiny. Like, you see the little sparkles in it. And it kind of looks like snow, but it kind of doesn't. It's just really blue and weird. Okay. So, we're just going to have to explore, because the world kind of forms up with you as you go. So, you can't really see if there's any ore until you get to where you're going. See right there. Okay, so there's some more compound up here, and you can, oh wait, what is that down there? That's just more compound. Compound is actually a really common material, but like the world I have, like my other world, so hard to find it, because I've gotten most of it. There's not a lot left, so we're gonna go ahead and get this compound while we're here. Because we might as well. We're going to need it. But we do need resin. Oh, shit. Okay, there's resin. Sweet. All right, we're going to go ahead and get... Well, we don't have any room. Yeah, we have room for one. All right. We're going to take this one back. And I'll be right back so you guys don't have to sit there. Okay, guys, so we just made it back. What I'm going to do really quick is I'm going to put a few of these out. And we're going to actually build this. All right. And then we're just for now, we're going to put these on here just to free up some space in our inventory. Where could we actually think I saw. Okay, we're gonna put it right there. All right, I didn't know you could do that. So we just freed up some space, so we're gonna go back and we're gonna hopefully get up all that resin so we can bring it back. And I actually built a little bridge up here. You can I'll show you how I did it real quick. You can actually use your tool thing, and you can press, I don't know what it'd be on the computer, but you can press RV and LB to switch it. This means you're gonna dig with the arrows going in. This means you're going to expand or build up, the arrows going out. This means you're gonna flatten. So for example, if you wanted to build like a bridge, you could start with like a surface of the height you want, like right here. You can just kind of build it out and it will flatten everything. There you go, bridge. It's really cool how it works. It's got like a really cool way of working, like the mechanics for it are obviously not something we haven't seen before, but it's something we don't see often, I guess you could say. Shut up, computer. But it's really unique how it works. So we're gonna go ahead and get up all this just so we'll have the materials, because you're gonna need a lot of resin. Resin is another key component in just about everything you build in this game. So we're gonna try to get as much as that. And we actually don't need any compound right now. And it's not daytime, so like my thing is not refilling right away. Come on. Okay. We want at least one more. There's one right here. Can we get one more? Is there any more underneath all this? Yeah, there's one. Yep, there's one. There's one. Can we get one more? Yeah, alright. So, come on, let me out. Let me out. Alrighty. So now we're going to go ahead and run this back. And I'll see you guys in just a second. Okay, so we just made it back. And what we're going to do now is we're going to... let's see. Yeah, we're going to take this off. Like so. And we're going to put our resin on there. And we're going to build... We're going to build a researcher. So compounds used for research. Now, should be able to research things. So I think we'll go over there and get something. I'll show you how to research. So the way you research things, I'm gonna make some more tethers, is you'll find these gigantic things around the map that you have to dig up, and you'll notice you can pick them up, and in doing that you bring it back to the researcher and you put it on there and you research it, and it opens up and it'll either give you an item or it'll give you a schematic, like a blueprint to build something. And that's how you unlock new things to build. So I'm gonna go over here. I'm gonna dig this in. Anything under it? Yeah, sometimes you'll find some really cool stuff underneath it. Okay, it just goes down. There's nothing under it. Nothing under that. Wait. What is this? Alright, so here is something you can actually research. So I'm gonna take that. And the easiest way I found to maneuver this stuff, because it's a little annoying trying to pick it up and bring it with you. So just run it and then just, oh, I grabbed the tether. So just kind of grab it up and then drop it like out in front of you. And then you can run a lot faster to get up to the side. All right, that should get it on the researcher. And it's powered, obviously it has to be powered. The power has to be full before you can research something. Click that button and let it go to work. You notice it uses all of your power, but what did we get? You got a fuel condenser. I don't know what that's for either. There's a lot of stuff in this game that I still don't understand yet. But for the most part, it's pretty self-explanatory. And you can actually save your game by sitting in your pod. Which is another thing I didn't tell you. I like how I'm explaining all this stuff, and like I have no idea how long this game has been out, and I know it's on PC, so I know a lot of you people probably know everything about it by now. But obviously, you know, me explaining all this stuff is for mainly for people who don't know a lot about the game yet. Ooh, what is that? See, I've never seen some of this stuff. So can we dig this? We can't. Okay, so what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to build ourselves up. So let's go on up. And let's see, let's get our flattened tool. There we go, we got a little path. Okay. And you can actually take fall damage, so. Oh, okay. We're just gonna throw all this stuff down so we can get to it. Because I don't know. This is really cool, though. I've never seen this before. I've never seen all this stuff, like, in this way. We'll come back for that. So we're gonna go ahead and take this one. And put it on. Oh, stop it. Put it on the researcher. And then we're gonna press the research button. It's gonna go to work. Ta-da! What's gonna get? What are we gonna get? Trucks, sweet. So trucks are like the rovers. The only difference is the trucks are bigger, and you can hold a lot more stuff on it. And there's storage. There's storage things you can buy, or you can build in the printer. And you can place a storage unit on it and have even more storage. And that's just a really easy, good way to go out and grab a lot of resources at once. So we're going to have to wait until we can charge this. Actually, you know what we could probably do? We need copper. There's copper over here. We have copper. So there's another way of going about fueling. Why did that drop it? There's another way about going... fueling your stuff. So you can actually build a generator, which you can use to power your machine. So you take the generator, get off my screen. You don't have to place it right there. I'm actually not gonna place it right there because a vehicle can attach that and break it off. So I'm gonna do it right there. And once you have a generator placed, you need to get some organic substances. So we're gonna go ahead and break all this up. Get an organic stack. Okay, so with the organic stack, bring it over here. And grab that. Place it on. Oh, no. 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 Damn it. It's a little wonky. Takes some getting used to, but. Alright, you, as you can see, it's consuming the organic, but it's fueling the researcher. And then once it fuels it up, and it won't stop. Like, if you do this and you have fuel, it's still going to consume all of it. So only use it when you need it. See, it's still going to consume all of it. So we're going to hurry up and use it, maybe get some of the fuel back out of it. What did we get? Trade platform. Okay, so we can already build those. I don't know why it gives you stuff you already have, but then again, I haven't, like, I don't know. You might not already have it. I think I saw it. I think you do have it, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just an idiot. Anyways, so we're gonna get some more organic. Oh, look, there's some resin over there. I didn't even know that. I wasn't paying attention. All right. So we're gonna And of course, you could just wait until day because we have the solar panels. But I'm an impatient little fuck. So we're going to go ahead and fuel it now. The cube. My name is Optimus Prime. And this is the cube. The Allspark. Look at it. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's so very, very beautiful. Okay, it's done. So while that's researching, I'm gonna go and grab this. Nope. Power cells. Because we didn't have that available. Now we have power cells, yeah. I don't know what power cells does, I've never built them. But you know what? Let's see what they do. So we have power cells. So can you charge Okay, there's another way of charging it. And I guess when the power cells run out, it's just gone. So does this regenerate, or... Maybe when there's power running to it, it'll refill it. That might be what it does, so... I'm gonna go ahead and research this really quick. It seems like, it kind of feels like the nights go like really, really slow and the days go really fast. Habitat. What is, I've never gotten that. Okay, we gotta build that. Let's go get, actually we have some resin. So let's put the resin on there. And let's go get some more resin. Please, sir, can I have some more? Some more resin. Give me all your resin.
All belong to me.
Give me. Oh shit. Give me. You're just gonna have to keep feathering it. No other way of doing it. And we might as well get as much as we can. Take it back. Okay, it's getting daylight, so I guess now I can find out if. Oh wait, I want to finish up this stack. The hell? I was gliding. Because if you have a stack and you don't finish it and you grab a different material before you finish the stack, you lose the stack, like I said earlier. So, running low on oxygen. I need to go ahead and make the oxygen tank whenever I can. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. Alright, so we need to make a printer, but I want to see something. Yeah, fuel condenser. That might be to make fuel, because I know you can build the fuel containers, so that might be actually to make fuel. Smelter, vehicle bay, trade platform, printer. That's weird. Alright, so what do we need? We need copper. We have one copper. What could we make that would not require aluminum? Fuck, okay. So probably what we're gonna have to do is go back down in the cave. And I believe, ooh, what is that big ass flower thing over there? Let's go back out here because there's some materials you can usually find out here that you can't find. Well, I mean you can, but it's a closer way of getting the material. If we can find it. Okay, so I don't know if you'll be able to use this stuff for like scrap later, because see there's a thing right there. You could probably... No, it just doesn't work. So, you could probably find stuff attached to that. Okay, I have some tethers, so we're gonna... Oh, shit. Is that what I think it is? Where is it? Oh, there it is. It's a-coming. Oh, shit! We're fucked now, buddy! We are so fucked! We're so fucking fubbernucked. I'm just kidding. Get in the... Okay. So now we just sit here and wait out the storm. Fun. Oh, this looks like death. So when a storm hits, your only real option is to get inside of your pod. It can't destroy your structures as far as I know. Because there's a lot of rocks that fly around whenever you're... Yeah, see, there's the rocks. And those will kill you. Pretty easily. Like, you can just get hit by one and you'll just die. So you gotta be very careful when a storm like this comes through. So I guess we're just gonna wait it out. No other option.
It is now day 11. I've been trapped in this pod for what feels like an eternity. I've been eating my own shit to survive. I feel that my demise is going to be very soon. If I do perish out of here, make sure this log gets to my wife. Tell her she was a whore, and the mailman had AIDS. And I hope she dies in hell. Burns in hell. I forgot to mention that I'm mentally retarded.
Okay, it's over. Alrighty. We're fine. I wasn't worried. Did I look worried? Because I wasn't. I knew we were gonna be fine. I knew it. Look at this little guy jump. Look at him go. Look at him go. Look at him go. Okay, so put one up here. Okay, there's some more resin. We actually don't need this right now, so we're not gonna take it. But we need to remember it's here. Doesn't seem to be really anything we need out here. It's just kind of an open nothingness. But we know where some compound is. And there's also these things which give you oxygen. Sometimes they don't want to fucking work. You can actually take these. And, we might as well. We might as well take as much as it's willing to give us. So, can we get back on the... yeah, here we go. It's got to be on the arrow. Okay. So, we have an extra oxygen thingy. I'm pretty sure... if I take it... okay, it's consuming it. Alright. Now, what's cool about this game is that it automatically marks your home, which is right there. But if you get too far out, you can't see it. And it butt fucks you. Like, literally, it bends you over and fucks you. I'm kidding. But I had a very bad experience with the things not showing up. I lost my rover. I lost all the material I had on me. It was just not fun. And I fell under the map a couple times. But it's okay. It's okay. Perfectly fine. That's A-okay. So obviously you don't have to rely on the tethers at all times. But rely on the tethers at all times. Tethers are your best friends in this game. And you want to make sure that they're your buddies. Okay, so it just disappears. Little power node things just go away. Ooh, lithium! We need that! Alright. So now that we have lithium, we can make... wait, what was it? A battery. And I think... let's go ahead and make a battery. Alrighty, so you can actually... oh, I have a... what we're gonna do. We're gonna actually think you can do this. Will that charge the battery? What if we... put it right there. Or... yeah, it's not gonna have enough. It's gonna stop after this, or will it? Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. It's not gonna have enough to fill the battery up, or will it? Oh, just enough. Okay, so with the battery attached, when this runs out, obviously the battery will start to refuel it. And I think the battery will last a little longer than this will. So we're going to test that out soon, hopefully. Can we make a... oh, we gotta have the printer first. And copper. Alrighty. So, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna come out to this tether. But from this tether, we're gonna link it to that cave together. We're actually gonna make a way down right here. Just because I don't feel like going around. Is this an effective, safe way down? Is it the best way down? Is it worth risking life or death going down this way? It'll be fine. Okay, I don't think I can get out, so. That works. I'll be able to get out that way. Okay, let's go ahead and put another tether right there. We're gonna go ahead and work on making a way down. So where's the floor? There's the floor. Okay, so can we get back up this way? Okay, we can. Can we completely get down this way? Yeah, okay. So we're gonna put a tether right here. And we're gonna make a tether stretch over here. See, those plants, I'm pretty sure, are evil. So you wanna be careful. So, yeah. This is what we need. This is our copper. We're gonna get a lot of this. See, there's one that always floats for some reason. Okay. So we have a full inventory, so we're gonna go ahead and head back right now. I'm not touching that. See, we have power running. See, that's what those yellow lines right there. Well, I'm pretty sure you saw them. The little yellow bar is running through it. That means there's power running at our base, and there's power flowing, so it's gonna charge us. It's gonna charge our power pack as we go because there's power flowing through it. So that's a good thing to remember. Okay, so we're back at the base. We're gonna go ahead and okay, it's daytime. So our power should be flowing infinitely. So while it, what am I doing? This is not the smelter. What am I doing? Go. And we can go ahead and build this. Wait, don't I have? Oh, it's up here. Alrighty. Oh shit, did I? Ah, damn it. I did exactly what I told you guys to be wary of. I lost a piece. No, that's okay. So, with the printer, you can build a variety of things. It's gotta be charged up first, obviously. Oh, I gotta stop kicking the shit out of stuff. Alright, so, there's a solar panel. We do actually want one of these, but we can't build one just yet because we don't have any. Well, we do have compound over there. Storage. We want this. Not yet, though. Battery, generator, habitat, compound. Oh! That's what that is! You can expand! Okay! So you can put another pod somewhere else and have a second base. That is cool! I didn't know that! Alright! And then there's a seat for you get a vehicle, solar panel, blah, blah. So what we're gonna do really quick is we're gonna build on a solar panel because we have compound over here. Oh, it's right there. Okay, yeah, sometimes your stuff will appear. Let me make sure it's recording right. Sometimes your stuff will appear down here and you'll be like, what the fuck, where was it? Okay, we're gonna make another solar panel, and this is a bigger solar panel and it requires more space, and that's where this comes in. I want that to be straight. Okay, so we're gonna take this. And see, what we can do is we can actually, well, see, you have to have two slots. So we're gonna place that there, and that's a bigger solar panel. We're gonna use this particular one to expand outwards and have, this is gonna be our expansion power thing. So we're gonna use this one to expand out. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and I want it straight. It's gonna bug me if it's not straight. There we go. Okay, now that we have that one, cause see, you can expand from them like this. So we're gonna use those to expand, and this isn't charged. Is the battery used up? Yeah, the battery's all used up. Okay, so what we're gonna do, oh shit, get out. Well, that saved our game, so we're good. Can we make, we need aluminum to make a wind thing. We don't have any aluminum. We're gonna go ahead and expand this out. Oh, do I not? Oh yeah, I was gonna say, I know I have one more. Okay, so we're gonna leave it like that. We may use this one to build another structure, like a vehicle thing, or vehicle depot, whatever. But for now, we'll leave it like that. So that's about all the time I have for this video. I'm going to leave it off right here because we actually got a lot done. We did a lot this episode, and this is going to be the first episode of the series of this game I'm going to start. So I'm going to see how far we can get, and as we build, the game will hopefully get updated as we go, and there'll be more stuff for us to do and more stuff for us to discover and build and just, you know, great stuff. And we'll get to the dying and all that other fun stuff later. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to smack that like button or whatever form of advantage you prefer, show your support for my channel, and why not subscribe? Because if you enjoyed this video, you enjoy everything else I'll post on my channel. I try to upload daily for the most part. Check out my Patreon. You don't have to donate, but it's there if you want to look over and drop me a few dollars while you're there. And I've got t-shirts and coffee mugs and dildos and butt plugs and everything your heart could desire. Link will be in the description below for you guys to go look over. Either way, you guys have been an amazing audience, and I will see all of you wonderful, beautiful people in the next video. Goodbye, guys.